Hello friends, welcome to my channel Smart Study with Yash. Today in this video, we are going to start another chapter of physics, which is electricity. Friends, you might be familiar with the word electricity as it is an important source of energy in our modern times. Electricity is used in our homes, industries and in transport also. It is for lighting fans, heating purpose, many more. Now, before learning more about electricity, we must be familiar with the word charge. Okay, you might have observed that while we rub a scale to our head, hair or comb, the small papers get attracted. It is because of charge. Charge gets stored in the comb. Okay, now what is charge and there are types of charge. We have two types of charges. Okay. First one is the positive charge. Another one is negative. Okay. Negative charge. Now, how do we consider that this charge is positive? It is actually defined that when a glass rod, okay, when a glass rod is rubbed on a cloth, so the charge acquired by the glass rod would be positive, okay, and when an ebonite rod, ebonite rod is rubbed on a woolen cloth, okay, then the charge occupied would be negative charge on the ebonite rod. Okay, now let us discuss some of the properties of charges. The first property, which you might have read earlier also, that opposite charge, opposite charges attract each other. Okay. And similar ripple. Similar charges ripple each other. Okay. Now these were the two properties of charges. Now what, let us discuss about charge, more about charge, that is, what is negative charge or what is positive charge? It is actually charge acquired, but in quantitative analysis. Okay, so the negative charge occupied is equal to electronic charge, which is E. It is given as 1.6 into 10 to power minus 19, but charge is negative. And similar with the proton, a charge occupied by a proton, it is charge occupied by an electron, and by proton it would be positive, 1.6 into 10 to power minus 90 coulomb. Okay, coulomb is the unit of charge. Now what is, how can we define a charge? It is electronic charge. Now how can we define a charge occupied by an object or any other substance? It is given by a formula, Q equals to Ne. Here Q is the charge, net charge, and N is the number, it is in whole number. Okay, N is here whole number, and E is the electronic charge. E is what? It is electronic charge. Now what this is actually based on quantization, that the charge occupied by a substance would be in the terms of electronic charge. Okay, that it would be 1e, 2e, 3e and so on. Now let us do a numerical. Okay, the problem which we have is that we have to find number of electrons, okay, for 1 coulomb charge. 1 coulomb charge we have given, and we have to find the number of electrons. Okay, so since what we know that Q equals to Ne, okay, Now, what is the charge given? It is 1 coulomb. We have to find number of electrons, and electronic charge is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. Okay, now what we would do? We would just take this to the denominator. 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. And so what we are going to do is that we are going to take minus 19 on the numerator side. 10 to the power 19 by 1 by 6 is our n. Now what we get n on solving, we get is 6.25 into 10 to the power 18. So these are the number of electrons which are going to be possessed by an 1 coulomb of charge. Okay, now the next topic which we are going to see is conductors. What are conductors? Conductors are the substances which conduct electricity through them. Okay, that means they allow the flow. They allow the flow through them. Now, what are these substances? Example, we have copper, silver, etc. Okay. Now, on contrary, we have insulators. Insulators, they don't permit the flow. Okay, now example, plastic, rubber, etc. That's why we have plastic covering on wires. Okay, so that wires might be shock proofed. Okay, now this was about conductors and insulators. Okay, now we have to deal with more topics. I would be describing more topics in my later video. This was the introductory part. Hope you find this video helpful. Do like and share my video. If you haven't subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to get notified with my later videos. Thank you.